Okay, great. And I would like to give a shout out. Scotty Orenstein is Lowndes County Commissioner. He came and showed up and stayed for the whole thing. Thank you, Scotty, as well as DeMarcus Marshall. Thank you both for showing up. Appreciate that. Sandra Tulio's around. There she is. Thank you, City Councilwoman. Vivian Cody. There she is. Thank
Alvin.
You so much.
Alvin.
Who else?
Alvin.
Oh, Alvin, thank you for showing up. Appreciate it. Do we have a winner for the trivia contest?
We may or may not. There seems to be some confusion as to the procedure that we followed this evening. As a result, I have received only two papers. So, Chris,
you got one behind you over
here. I think my idea is this. To put all of you on the honor system, I have two tables. One of them came in at 50%, the other came in at 80%. One of those tables, however, was my table, and people might suspect that there was some wrongdoing here. What I want to do is this. I will give you the answer, please, have somebody, one person at each table remaining, to grade your test, and I'll give you the answers. And when I do that, you can decide who the winner is. And I can tell you then what the huge, really huge, and unbelievable prize is going to be. So one person at each table. Yeah. That's what I do. Number one question was, Mr. Trump claims that he is the presumptive nominee of the Republican Party because he has won 13.3 million votes cast in the GOP caucus for primaries, more than any other Republican in history, including Ronald Reagan, blah, blah, blah. So, the number of presidential election voters is approximately, the answer is D, 130 million. So, Ms. Trump has received about 10% of the votes that we cast in this presidential election cycle. Number two, Ms. Trump, should he win Donald J. Trump win the majority of electoral votes in 2016, he will be Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces. What is the extent of his military experience? He fought in Korea, Vietnam, and the First Gulf War, ultimately attaining the rank of Lieutenant Colonel. B, he attended a military prep school in New York City. C, he was a conscientious objector on religious grounds. D, he was an ROTC cadet at his alma mater, the Wharton School, a.k.a. the greatest business school in the world. And the correct answer is, he attended a military prep school in New York City. Number three, stars have concluded that the last Republican president who was more strongly anti-free trade than Donald J. Trump was B. Warren G. Harding. Four, recently, several of the pollsters who were closest to calling the 2012 presidential election perfectly concluded that the probability of Donald J. Trump's winning the 2016 election is A, 20%. Number five, DJT has floated several trial balloons concerning his likely running mate for vice president, which incidentally is to be decisions to be made by the end of this week. Which of the following balloons is most likely to include the vice presidential nominee? A, Donald Cruz and Marco Rubio. B, Joni Ernst and Bob Corker. C, Duke Ingrich and Christie. And D, George W. Bush, number 43, and Susana Martinez, the governor of New Mexico. Since Ernst and Corker have both dropped out, Cruz and Rubio are unlikely to be considered. That leaves C, actually. Newt Gingrich, or Chris Christie. Number six, when DJT is elected and builds the wall in Mexico, who is going to pay for it? Turn that over later. Who is going to pay for it? A, Mexico, as Donald Trump says. B, nobody, because he will not be elected. C, the Army Corps of Engineers. D, nobody, because virtually every engineer, architect, and economist believes that the cost would be so prohibitively high that it would completely bankrupt the country. The correct answer to that would be D. 7. How many electoral votes does it take to win a presidential election? The answer is A, 270. 8. Which of the following describes most closely a typical Trump voter? And the answer, correct answer is B, white male, poorly educated, NASCAR fan. 9. When asked in a TV interview his opinion of Brexit, Trump reported A, what?
You.
10. When asked in another TV interview what penalty women will have who have abortion must should suffer, DJT said, B, there must be a penalty, but I'm not sure what it should be, but if there's no punishment, blah, 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 blah. That's number 10. Anybody get all 10 of them correct? Okay, you're
I'm corralled to report. The Southwest stable got them all 100% correct, but there's a question about
what?
There's a question about the legitimacy of the results, so I would draw.
Okay, so you don't win. Want to know what the prize is?
No,
bidding?
I think the table would need to be
okay. Table 11, stand up. That's you guys. My table. Congratulations.
Thank you, Dick Sager, for putting the quiz together. We appreciate it. And DeMarcus Marshall would like to say something really quickly, and then we're going to wrap it up.
Hello, how's everybody doing? Thanks, Tom. I would be remiss if I didn't just have an honest conversation with y'all for a minute. Currently, there are a lot of protests taking place across the U.S. I think we as a party need to recognize that individuals are fighting for what they believe in. Yes, it is very bad to weaponize armed officers, but please do not forget what took place in Louisiana, Minnesota. Us for and what they're protesting for. And to keep in your hearts and minds that in prayers for those who are peacefully protesting, I am asking that they continue to peacefully protest, and I think we should. I think far too often in weeks like this, we only talk about the squeak wheel. Y'all know the thing, you know, squeak wheel gets low. You look at your form, you got this so-called top five, but you don't really see much about that. But I just got to tell you something from a personal standpoint. It's like the congressman said over in Texas. You know, I have a young black son. And I'll be the first to tell you, I don't want him to get shot by police. That doesn't mean I don't support the police 110%. Okay? But I got to tell you, it becomes harder and harder even today as a politician to not tell my son and my daughter there's no difference in them and the other kids. And that's just being honest, literal. And I think we got to have an honest discussion about it. But sometimes people wonder, you know, what are they talking about now? What are they talking about now? Okay? Because at the end of the day, you know, most of the time when a big scandal breaks or some kind of a Watergate thing comes about, people tend to go in the shadows and fight down, right? Well, in the back of Afro-American minds and minds like mine, I'm saying, well, is this what toned down is since it broke, I mean, these last couple of years? These last couple of months, what would it have been like without cell phones? That's what we're saying in our mind. And I think, you know, we got to tell everyone this. Because I'm a politician, but at the same time, I'm a man. And I got to be honest with you. And for the record, the Black Lives Movement is not a radical group, terrorist group, none of that. They're trying to peacefully and simple, but the media is painting different pictures. I'm not a Clarkston member of that organization, but I just got to say this because the squeaky oil always gets the oil. And far too often I see a lot of the issues that really matter to Afro-Americans sometimes just dwindle away. Forget the legislation and policy the way I want. That's my truth. Thank you all. Have a blessed night. That's all I have.
Thank you, County Commissioner DeMarcus Marshall. We would like to invite you to purchase some more Miller's Barbecue. Gretchen might be taking some money back there, but $10, and you can have a to-go box of Miller's Barbecue. So Again, all this money's going to help us get Democrats elected, so we'd like to invite you to that. Also, like to invite you, we have monthly meetings, if you're not aware. It's usually the first Monday of every month. Usually we have it at Mama June's restaurant, and we talk about all kinds of local issues. The transportation issue, we've been trying to get public transportation here in Lyons County. We're making a push for it. We need your help. Show up to the meetings. We can talk about education. We can talk about gun violence. So every month we talk about a new issue. So we hope to see you Monday. It's August 1st at Mama June's restaurant. It's always 6 p.m. They got great food there. So we'd love to see you there. And we're also going to be electing officers at the next meeting.
Committee members.
I'm sorry. We're going to be electing committee members at the next meeting. So it's a very important meeting. We'd love to see you there. If you want to say hi to me or Mayor Ted Terry or Gretchen, anybody, we'd love to talk with you. Thanks so much for showing up. We really appreciate it. And let's get Democrats elected in November. Thank you.